United Nations Association's SDG Changemakers program. This is a program that has had some experience in the past. It's also involved, and you'll meet several people through this introductions this morning. But this is the first year that we've come together to partner, and we're very excited about Changemakers working directly with United Nations Association. So this is the leadership team. Notice how many people have come together to make this possible for all of us. There are people all over St. Louis that are aware that you as a group have come together in this room today.
Welcome you all to this Changemakers, SDG Changemakers Youth Action Program. Really excited to work with you, to learn from you, and all to work together towards how we can create sustainable, positive change and impact, of course, within how it relates to the 17 global goals or sustainable development goals. This program is really about you and how we can work together. Obviously, there's people from different backgrounds, different perspectives, different high schools participating, so it's really about how can we have fun together working towards these goals.
If everybody wants to say, hey, Juan.
Hi, Juan.
This is Renee.
Hi.
The main message I would like to share with you is that your work, the impact that you have every day matters. We work with people all over the world to design and help design the Sustainable Development Goals of the United Nations.
As we get to the end of this week, you will have a chance to move from thinking about yourselves to thinking about others, from learning more about the perspectives of others, to how do you become an informed activist beyond just conversations, beyond just Google searches, to how do you then put all of that together to think about how you take action in the course of the year, because that's really what we're aiming for. Your work is not going to begin until after this program is over. The second week, we're going to be out in the weeds. We're going to get to go out into different parts of St. Louis. We're going to experience those different sectors of the city. We're going to learn from the people that really know about those sections of the city while you in the afternoon start to think about what your action project is going to be. And then on that Friday, you come back and you sit here with your parents or whomever else you would like to invite, and you get a chance to present what is it you're going to do in the course of the year.
You just draw some stuff that represent you or your hobbies or what sports you like or basically anything like that. And you'll have 5 minutes, and after that we'll get into groups and you can share them with each other to figure out and explain why you chose what you chose to draw on.
So my first one, I did tennis, because I play tennis at Ursulines and I love it. And then this one is like my family, so I have an older brother and older sister with my parents. And then I also drew my dog because I'm obsessed with him. He has my whole heart.
This first one, I put education, like just because I think that's very important. And also, like my school, we did like a project on like the SDG goals, and I had like goal number 4, education. So like, I feel like I have a little more background on that one.
This is a little plant. I'm a vegan, and I've been vegan for 4 years now. It's just a really big part of my life, embracing that sustainability in my diet and lifestyle, and also respecting like the animals and the planet. And then I have a little smiley face because it's really important to just be positive to me. You know, there's like so much that we can focus on in the world that's like sad or depressing or something that's maybe not so fun to embrace, but I like to always approach things with some humor and some positivity.
And then I put like equality on there. I try my best at least to be like understanding, and that's something that I try to hold myself accountable to.
My first one kind of resonates with like my personality on being a foodie. So if you want to ever do a boba run, I'm the person to come with. And I also love baking, and I kind of do that on my own and just like helping people out in like society by delivering foods and like donating to charities with like baking, etc. And then this one down here is basically like all of the other parts of the world that I connect to.
We do campaigns on the simplest of things, like rights to have clean water, to be safe in your home, on the streets. And then we also publicly advocate to our legislatures for the UN and the rights that we all have.
All right, so the goal that was speaking to me today is the first one, no poverty, because it really bothers me that just because of chances that people have to live without their basic needs met, and they have to like be forced into doing things that they otherwise wouldn't want to do.
I believe it's a human right for everybody to have access to proper healthcare and proper medication. And as somebody who is interested in the medical field, I feel strongly that I should be able to take action and help these people get that mental and physical, their mental and physical needs met.
Hi, I'm Madison, and the goal that spoke to me today, like Rachel, was the good health and well-being. For me personally, I think the inequality and the mortality rate of black females while in labor is very important to me, and that's why I would like to focus on this one.
I picked no poverty, and I have actually a story for this. So I'm from India originally, and one side of my family is from Rajasthan, and we always had this long drive we used to take before we went to one of the temples by the mountains. I can't recall the name just yet, but there was this little girl that used to be there, and we used to see her like every year we used to visit India. And her family used to make different pieces of jewelry, like, you know, usually based on the different gods. But they also made like earrings, necklaces. So the earrings I'm wearing right now, those are actually the ones she made. And we used to always provide food for her. And we went in like our last few visits and she unfortunately passed away. So it's tiny stories like that that make me wish that the world didn't have poverty and we worked towards all being at the same level.
I chose goal number 11, which is sustainable cities and communities. And it's not actually the lack thereof that's inspired me. It's the fact that during my lifetime, I've really seen a spike in sort of urban areas, you know, there's vertical farming, urban farming, especially around here where people are finding ways, even in their living areas that wouldn't really seem as a place to make sustainable environments, they're finding ways to do so. And I think it'd be a real shame to see that trend just suddenly stop. And I think it's something that we could have in all parts of the world. So I want to see that on the rise.
We are so fortunate to have so many phenomenal speakers coming in to the room at the SDG Changemaker. It's really been a group effort to have those that come. And on our first day, we had Arrey Obenson, who is the president and CEO of the International Institute, who spoke to our kids about what does it mean to be part of St. Louis? What are the challenges that we face as a world? And how important it is that we come together.
And so young people around the world decided that the next time we cannot allow our future to sit in the hands of leaders who wear jackets and suits and sit in a room and decide what the future of the world will look like. Young people decided that they will play a role in determining what the future of the world was going to look like.
The SDG Changemaker program was developed when a number of us came together and recognized that there's so many phenomenal things happening in our city. And we wanted to give our youth, who are coming from different backgrounds, from different schools, from different experiences, the opportunity to come together and feel a sense of solidarity in what it means to be part of St. Louis and to recognize that we have triumphs and challenges and to look at them through the lens of the Sustainable Development Goals. An SDG Changemaker is one that recognizes that it takes collective action to make change, understanding the community itself and making having deep conversations with members of our community to be able to understand those needs, to understand the reasons why those challenges exist, to hear the stories of others.
Involving youth as changemakers is extremely important because the youth is our future. They're our tomorrow. Young people can learn so many things by going through a program such as the SDG Changemakers. They can learn real life experiences. They can be educated. The voices from the metropolitan area are so important because St. Louis, such as so many other cities and the world globally, is a melting pot. And there are history, there are past, present, and our future. An SDG Changemaker to me is a variety of things. It's taking your experiences that you've learned at whatever age you are to date and involving them with what you've learned in school, from your community, from your parents, and it's taking action with those, finding a purpose and making solutions for the world to be better.
I decided to participate in the program because I wanted to actively make change in the St. Louis community, change that I wasn't already making alone. I feel like what was most instrumental during this program was being able to go into communities and meet the people living there. Like Minerva, for example, in Cherokee Street was an amazing opportunity to meet somebody from a different background and to learn about their struggles. An SDG changemaker to me is someone who's prepared and ready to actively make change and has an open mind and heart to all the situations that people that you may come across in the world go through. Mostly, I've enjoyed like making connections with all the other changemakers, as well as meeting those people in the communities that like need that help and that we can actively make change toward.
I decided to participate in the program because I worked with like a St. Louis charity who's focused on sustainable development in other countries, and the lady I work with sent me like a link to the program. It's like, you should totally try this, and I didn't really know what to expect from it, but I'm glad I kind of just took the leap of faith and decided to like learn something new, to actually like go into communities and listen to other people's stories. Because as much as we did learn in like an innovation hall and we got to hear so many speakers, I felt like it was instrumental to learn about people's own experiences and stories. I've enjoyed like meeting the people who also came to this program, and just meeting a lot of people my age who are passionate about the same things as I am and who want to learn just like me. A changemaker to me is really anybody that wants to do something positive for their community, even in like the smallest steps. They just want to make a change. One thing I would tell others to make a change is, it doesn't have to be something big. It can be like the smallest action in the world, but you're still doing it, and that's really all that matters when it comes down to it.
So I first decided to participate in the program because I was able to realize that I have the potential to make a difference in the world, and I don't want to keep my own potentials locked up in a cage when there's so many things in the world that should be changed. One of the most instrumental things that I have learned is to persist. After hearing so many wonderful speakers and knowledgeable people give us their information, they've all gone through ups and downs, but with every single step they were able to persist and make it towards their end goal. Probably my most enjoyable experience was creating a song with the rest of the SDG changemakers.
So sharing opinions and ideas, and would you say that you are sharing your opinions and ideas in an effort to make
change?
Okay, so I'm sensing change as a theme.
I'm Jessica, and we're also, I mean, specifically learning about the SDGs, the 17 like goals, sustainable development goals for the world, and making change in those areas.
You're going deep. The SDGs. So you have six groups. Okay. I want each group, you have 10 minutes. Each group is going to get together, and I want you to come up with two sentences that express, this is why we're here. So you're gonna take 10 minutes, you're gonna get in your groups, and I want you to come up with, I don't wanna limit you, just come up with a statement of purpose. We'll do that, that sounds more official. Come up with a statement of purpose as to why you're here and what type of change
to see.
Go.
One sentence, or is that our two sentences?
I think that's two. So, creating a reality without the brutality, we can start a new future with a good mentality. That.
Most of your favorite songs, if you go and look at who wrote them, especially in your generation, it's like 20 people. Right? It's like written by such, 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 and all those people came together to write the song that you can't get out of your head. It takes a team, right? So, at the end of this exercise, what I'm trying to do is, I'm gonna take what you guys say. You tried to boil it down into groups of six. Now we have to take those six and find one cohesive statement that becomes an anthem, that we put some chords over. When the world is filled with sorrow, change today for tomorrow. Make our reality without the brutality, starting a new future with good mentality. We wanna change the world for the better. This is our home, we're gonna save it together. Y'all wrote that.
World is filled with sorrow, change the day for tomorrow, something like that.
Yeah.
Cause
yeah.
Then it could like,
now look, here's what's cool about that.
as soon as you started singing, I'm thinking, man, that sounds like a civil rights anthem. That sounds like a, which, where did Beyonce get a lot of her stuff from? Church. When the love is summer, So let's do this. Change. Stay. Oh, okay. Okay. You got a marker. So, are any of you in music? What's that first? What's that first chord?
A minor.
Okay. And how long we got A minor for?
For one bar.
One bar? And then what? One, two,
C.
C? Is it G? So then G?
G, yeah.
And then what?
E over F sharp.
You getting fancy. D over F sharp, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, play that.
When the world is filled with sorrow, change the day for tomorrow. Make our reality without reality. Start a new future with good mentality.
With something like that. Listen to what I'm saying, because y'all gonna sing it back to me.
But you thought I was gonna sit up here and write something and you gonna sit there? This is your song.
So this next part, we can keep the same chords.
We want to change the world for the better. Yeah. This is our home, we'll save it together.
That was hot. I don't know what you said. Oh! This is our home, we'll save it together. Paco, start playing. So let's do that second part. Go back to the top of the wind. When the world is filled with sorrow, change the day for tomorrow. Make our reality without mentality, a new future with good mentality. When the world is filled with sorrow, change the day for tomorrow. Make our reality without mentality, a new future with good mentality. Yeah.
This is our home, we'll save it together.
Oh, okay.
The world is filled with sorrow. Change today for tomorrow. Make our reality without brutality. A new future with good mentality. The world is filled with sorrow. Change today for tomorrow. Make our reality without brutality. A new future with good mentality. We want to change the world for the better. This is our home, we'll save it together. We want to change the world for the better.
Okay.
This is our home, we'll save it together.
Okay, so now
I mean, this is actually kind of dope.
An SDG changemaker to me is someone who believes in creating a difference, and no matter what their race, ethnicity, or social class is, they will be able to make that difference. One thing to motivate others that I would say is use your voice. You have that capability and use it to your fullest potential.
Honestly, I wanted to get outside of my comfort zone and I want to experience something new in different parts of the St. Louis community to see what areas I could make a change in. I've really enjoyed listening to the different speakers that we've had and the different professors and hearing everyone's different perspectives. To me, a change maker is someone who wants to make a difference in the world, no matter how old they are, no matter where they're from, or their social class or anything like that, someone who has the determination to make a difference. Something I would say to motivate others is to just go out in your community and see what needs to be changed and start somewhere, because no matter how old you are, you can make a difference.
What I've enjoyed the most during this program is definitely surrounding myself with such intelligent people who are super cultured and just super well-knowledged in their own fields. An SDG changemaker to me is someone who, I guess, has decided that their normal high school life isn't enough for them and they've taken it upon their own responsibility to make a difference. I'd say quit wasting time, you know. Your life's only so long, and every day you don't do something is another day wasted.
I see the SDG changemakers as really being the first step to bringing our region's youth voice to the forefront. And not only just telling them this is what we want you to do, they have the opportunity to co-create amongst themselves as well with regional stakeholders and leaders. What does that change look like in an equitable and sustainable type of way? I think it's important to involve youth because first and foremost, the children are our future and their voice needs to be amplified in creating a change as we go into this fourth industrial age. It would be the age of them. So let them power and infuse their voice and advocacy into the change that they want to see. The SDGs Changemaker Program can be the catalyst project for regional youth, national youth, to help amplify their voices and help them co-create the change that they want to see, not only with their fellow peers, but also to stakeholders, elected officials, and institutions.
We need you. We need our youth. We need our adults. We need our schools to come together and to recognize that we have opportunities for change. But we can't make it if we don't have a chance to get to know the members, all members of the St. Louis community, come together and take action.
My message as a change maker is just do it. Like, you're young and you can.
And together we can make a difference.
And together we can make a difference.
And together we can make a difference.
Together we can make a difference.